Yeah, and today we're going to talk about the District Development Council polls in Jammu and Kashmir. Now, a new democratic path has opened in Jammu and Kashmir with the first major electoral exercise after the abrogation of Article 370 provisions in the erstwhile state, which has now been divided into two union territories. We'll try and look at what exactly has happened in these DDC polls and the significance of this electoral exercise as far as Jammu and Kashmir is concerned. And for more on this, we're joined by a distinguished panel of guests. Let me first introduce them to you, beginning with Ms. Aarti Tikku Singh. She's a senior journalist, keeps a tab on all the developments there. We also have with us Mr. Praful Ketkar, the editor of Organizer. Welcome, both of you, to Rajya Sabha Television. And let me begin with you, Aarti. In a nutshell, if you look at this entire electoral exercise, how significant do you believe this is for Jammu and Kashmir?
Well, Vishal, I do think that this is a very significant chapter in the history of Jammu and Kashmir since independence, because this election has happened after the nullification of Article 370 and 35A and the reorganization of Jammu and Kashmir state into two union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. Why is it important and why is it historic? It's simply because Jammu and Kashmir until last year was under a certain system. It had a different relationship with the center, with the Union of India. And today it is in a different system and has a different way of looking at its relationship with the rest of India. Now, let me explain that. To begin with, till last year, it was a state. Today, it's a union territory. Second, the decentralization process, which essentially means taking democracy to grassroots level, has finally happened for the first time in Jammu and Kashmir. It did start with panchayat elections last year, but the next logical step would have been and should have been the District Development Council elections. And thanks to the central government, that has finally happened for the first time in the history of Jammu and Kashmir. Now, third point I want to make is that in the last 70 years, the funding for Jammu and Kashmir came from the center. Most of the funding, which is almost like 90% funding, came from the center. Mm-hmm. Jammu and Kashmir's revenue were not as significant. So the entire amount of funding would go to the state assembly, would go to the state government. State government would get the funds from the center and then they would disperse it among people, but different districts, depending on its own whims and fancies. In fact, most of the funding got concentrated in the summer capital of Jammu and Kashmir, which is Srinagar. That is why you see Srinagar is far more prosperous than any other part of Jammu and Kashmir, including Ladakh, which was a part of J&K till last year. Mm-hmm. This DDC election is going to ensure that the funding that's coming from center will go to the district level representatives who will on their own decide what kind of funding will go for what development, you know, depending on their own needs and requirements. So I think this is important from that perspective and also from the perspective that a lot of these mainstream politicians in Kashmir, whether it's Mehbooba Mufti or the Abdullahs Gray, they threatened that if Article 370 was nullified, there would be a lot of bloodshed in Kashmir. There would be nobody who would be hoisting the flag of India in Kashmir, that nobody would speak for India in Kashmir. But these results that we saw since yesterday that have come out from Jammu and Kashmir, they essentially show that people have shown their faith in Indian democracy rather than these mainstream politicians who were using the blackmail of Article 370 and also threatening the center with various measures. They are finally exposed because people have rejected them fair and square. They are not with them today because they did not even cross the halfway mark despite the fact that Gupkar alliance, which was an unholy alliance of opposition member, opposition parties coming together against the BJP and against the center, they have been defeated quite clearly because they did not even cross the halfway mark.
Okay. Indeed, definitely, as Aarti is pointing out, there's one thing which is pretty much clear through these polls, that is the electoral exercise, is the resounding faith of people in the democratic system. That's what is pretty much clear here, because of these elections being held very peacefully as well, and other several aspects. I'd like to now bring in Praful Ketkar here. Praful, from your point of view, what are the key highlights when we look at the DDC elections? This entire exercise, starting from the notification to the results, which are now in public domain.
See, Vishal, this election should be seen at three different levels. One is at the level of Jammu and Kashmir itself. The second level is the national level, and the third level is international level. I think the biggest message that this particular election has given globally, that through free and fair elections, India as a democracy is capable to defeat the politics of bullets through ballots. I think this is the most important message that we have conveyed. This is by any degree. See, everybody, the people who even boycotted the panchayat and the block level elections, they were forced to participate. And I'm just reinforcing the point made by Aarti, that now they have seen that the money is being directly transferred to the beneficiaries and the executing agencies at the grassroots level. So there was a pressure from below. And that is the essence of democracy. Now, this block development, district development council elections have reinforced this idea that any problem can be, India can handle any problem through democratic means. Secondly, national level, we have given a clear-cut message that the constitutional scheme of India can be extended and is applicable to each and every part of India. No part, excluded from this.
Okay.
Lastly, the people of Jammu and Kashmir, at one level, they force the people who boycotted the earlier election process, democratic process, they force them to participate. Then they participated in the election itself despite the threats given by certain elements. And now these results, this is not a sweeping victory for BJP either, but this definitely shows that there is a wind of change. The so-called mainstream political parties who were actually confined to the Srinagar Valley now have to accept the fact that then there has been a nationalist space in the entire Jammu Kashmir region, which is getting some voice through this election process. So there are multiple layers to this election. It is very significant and giving different levels of message to different constituencies.
Okay. Aarti, I'd like to come back to you. There is one more aspect to it, that, the successful conduct of these elections and the way people have come forward to cast their vote, participated in this electoral exercise, also paves the way for participatory politics and meaningful dialogue with all stakeholders, something which is very much required and which is the ultimate goal if you talk about the democratic process.
Absolutely, Vishal. One has to keep in mind that these elections have happened during the coronavirus pandemic. So the kind of poll percentage that came out, I think, is quite positive and very encouraging. But more than that, I would say that, they are encouraging also because look at the parliamentary elections that happened in 2019, and the performance and the poll percentage was abysmal. So from that perspective also, it is very, very encouraging. Third point I want to make is that in the last 1 year, if you noticed, the number of BJP activists, the number of BJP politicians who got targeted in Kashmir by terror groups was quite striking and quite alarming. And yet, people in Kashmir defied the sense of fear, defied the militant diktats, defied the poll boycott, which is a usual call of separatists in Kashmir. Despite that, people did come out to participate in elections. Now, one may argue that a lot of the Gupkar Alliance, for example, they've gotten a considerable number of seats in Kashmir Valley. Yet, I'm going to say that the fact is that the Gupkar Alliance also fought elections within the framework of Indian Constitution.
Exactly, that's
they
the point.
So they have also shown their faith in India's electoral democracy instead of, taking a different trajectory altogether and not being part of the bigger India story. So from that perspective also, I would say that it has opened up space for dialogue, for reconciliation, for different sections of society coming together to show that they essentially believe in the idea of India. Now, people may have different views about the constitutional positions and different views about what laws we should have and what laws we should not have. But the fact is that as of today, the poll results are telling you the story that people have rejected the majority in Kashmir, the majority in Jammu region, have rejected the agenda of the Gupkar Alliance. And their agenda, as we know, was the restoration of Article 370 and, of course, restoration of statehood. But clearly, people are not with them, even though they have gotten a fair number of seats. But one must keep in mind that they got these number of seats after having coming together. I mean, this is like, Congress and BJP coming together at national level and then fighting an election. That was the kind of conglomeration that Gupkar Alliance was about. Now, okay. From that point, I think what really has happened is that it has sent a message even to Kashmiri society that no matter what happens, the society in Kashmir and the society in Jammu will participate in electoral democracy and also work and function within the framework of Indian Constitution. And I think that's a big takeaway from that. Plus, it is also a message to people across the border. Look, Prime Minister Imran Khan of Pakistan, he went around the world. He was in Washington, D.C. He was camping in D.C. for a long time. His entire cabinet was traveling to D.C. every second day to project as if India had gobbled up Kashmir, as if India had really done something, something which was unacceptable by reorganizing the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So this is a resounding response to them too, that people in Jammu and Kashmir do not buy Pakistani narrative.